Hi, my name is Andy, and this is my first game dev video. For the next 72 hours, I plan to hold a personal game jam. I've never participated in an official game jam before, and I just want to see how much I can accomplish in just 3 days. For those of you who don't know what a game jam is, a game jam is typically a competition where participants try to create a video game from scratch in the shortest amount of time. This competition normally lasts from 24 to 72 hours. Most game jams have a theme that is announced just before the contest starts. I chose a selection of themes and had one randomly assigned to me just before my very own game jam started. I have set the following three rules. First, you have 72 hours to create the game. Second, the game is based on a theme. Third, the use of third-party assets, scripts and libraries is allowed. At the time of the game jam, there was a sale on the Unity Asset Store. It came in handy because it included a lot of helpful assets to quickly create prototypes. I just need a theme and then I'm ready to go. I found this website to be able to visualize the random selection. I did a little research and the most popular Rage games are probably the following. Let's see if I get inspired by the game designs. So, what is my definition of a Rage game? When you die or make a mistake, it should be punishing. That means no or very few checkpoints. And challenging parts will have to be repeated to perfection. Okay, let's get started. Technically, I'm starting Thursday evening, so... Let's start with a little brainstorming. For this, I created Trello board to record my thoughts. A 3D platformer is a perfect genre for a Rage game. I think a third-person controller with simple inputs appeals to me, like classic Mario games. If you fall, you die. Maybe the game should take place above the clouds. A few more ideas. Should there be a time limit? Is time pressure the right thing to do in a Rage game? I think checkpoints are something good in Rage games too. Maybe you can only use them once? It would be cool if the character can react to physical forces. So obstacles and traps must also have physical forces. Speaking of traps, how about fire traps? And what about projectiles? Blades? Oh, and of course moving platforms. Maybe a few more notes about the mechanics. Double jumps always work. Maybe integrate a dash mechanic? Movement, aka locomotion. Bumpers like in Sonic games? I have a lot of ideas going through my head right now. How about something like coins? Collectibles? And tie those collectibles to a game end condition? Like a locked door or something? A day and night cycle would be cool too. Oh, I forgot an important trap. Explosives. Besides moving platforms, maybe add rotating platforms? And maybe the world can be pirate themed, that would be cool. A flying pirate ship that shoots cannonballs at you, that would be so cool. Thank you. basic concept. I made some sketches in Photoshop. Now it's time for development. For this project, I'm using the game engine Unity, which I've worked with in the past on all of my projects. When creating a project in Unity, you have to choose a render pipeline first. There are a few things to consider here. However, I'm not aiming for hyper-realistic graphics, I'm a solo developer and I'm under a lot of time pressure. I also want all of my purchased assets to be compatible if possible. So I go with the default render pipeline here. The first thing I do in a new project is to make a few adjustments. I change the color space from gamma to linear. The linear color space is more precise and has a smoother blending between colors. Gamma is often too bright, resulting in white pixels. Next, I use the Package Manager to import the assets I need. ProBuilder to create quick blockouts directly inside the engine. Post-processing to make post-processing in the project possible at all. I would also like to have this prototype pack to be able to quickly and easily drag prototype prefabs into my level. Now I'm creating a quick blockout to create and test my character logic. I add a few of the prototype assets to have obstacles. I forgot to add the CineMachine asset. I use CineMachine to create my third-person camera and have it move in orbit around my character. I add the CineMachine components and play with the settings a bit. I guess it looks pretty good so far. Before I continue, I would like to have a character model that I can swap with the capsule later. This website offers free models and animations. I now start with the character logic. For this, I use the character controller component of Unity. I have used this component several times in the past. However, I have forgotten everything again and have to look up on some things. After about an hour, I have a working character controller. I think that's enough for today. I'm tired and will continue tomorrow morning. A new day. Today I would like to start directly with something else. I'm importing a free asset to have a different skybox in my scene. After that, I want to add some basic post-processing effects. I add effects like ambient occlusion and bloom and adjust the sliders a bit. It is always important to use the effects decently. I'll adjust the settings later when I've created some parts of the level. Now I add the new character model. Set it to have a humanoid rig and make it compatible with humanoid animations. I also imported a few more animations in the meantime. Okay, let's create a small test area to test character logic with the new model and animations. That looks much better right away. I also put a light tone shader on the environment. I think that's the style I want. To get a bit of variety, I'm now going to find a few particle effects. Firstly, an effect for dying, and secondly, an effect for respawning. I think I know which ones to use. Unfortunately, I remembered in the middle of the second day that Unity's character controller component is not based on a rigid body. That means the character can't react to physics. That's bad. So I programmed a new character controller. To be fair, I imported Easy Character Movement 2 from the Asset Store, which I've used many times in the past. After a few hours, I'm now back to the state of the old character controller. The advantage is that I now can react to physics. To test this out, I add a few moving platforms. These platforms are also rigid bodies. Okay, that doesn't look too bad. I also implemented a death logic. Let's test it. Now proper respawn logic is missing, and of course the particle effects. I have created falling platforms. I would like to test these and then I will go to sleep. It's been a long day, I've done a lot, but still have a lot more to do tomorrow. I think this works. The last day has begun. It will be a long day and I have many to-dos ahead of me. I now need a few platforms and traps that I will place in the actual game. Let's duplicate these platforms a few times. I have created animations for these wooden wheels. Let's see if the character moves correctly on them. Nice. The first trap I have in mind is a swinging blade. You have to dodge it with the right timing. As a second trap, I create a moving flamethrower. For this one, I use a particle effect and assign a death collider to the object. When the character touches the blade or fire, the death logic is triggered. Unfortunately, there's not much time left. I have to go back to work tomorrow. As you can see, the death and respawn logic is working now. I also added the particle effects. I created a simple in-game UI to visualize the game time and the number of deaths. It's not pretty, but it's functional. The final day is coming to an end and so is my game jam. I would like to present my outcome of the last 72 hours. I have created a short level with a little variation. I also added these little puffs of smoke on the character's feet. These appear when you run fast. By the way, the character can be controlled with keyboard and mouse, as well as with gamepad. As you can see, I also added a first concept for checkpoints. These can be triggered, but there's no logic behind it yet. Unfortunately, I didn't get any further. I had three really successful days. I had a lot of fun and renewed some of my knowledge. I even had so much fun that I want to continue working on the game and plan to create a mini devlog series for it. Should I finish the game, I would like to publish it on Steam as well. If you have any ideas for further development, I'm very curious. Lastly, If you see the video at a later date, I will post the Steam link below the video. I would be grateful if you could wishlist the game. Thanks, and until the next video. Bye.